Mr. Speaker, I rise today simply to remind America of Southwest Louisiana's plight in the wake of Hurricane Laura. While the national media and much of America has moved on, I will not allow the people of Louisiana to be forgotten here in Congress. Just 2 weeks ago, my district witnessed the most powerful hurricane in our state's modern history. Sustained winds above 150 miles per hour, a storm surge over 10 feet, a catastrophic loss across much of the state. Thousands of families have been displaced. Many are still without power, without water or access to the internet, without sanitation. Virtually all infrastructure, public and private, was heavily damaged. Behind me are images from my district. These are not isolated examples. This is every street, every neighborhood, and every business across two entire parishes of Southwest Louisiana and beyond. I'm grateful to President Trump for his quick response. He was on the ground just as soon as we could safely land Air Force One. I'm grateful for his response and his strong commitment. I'm so thankful for the outpouring of support from faith-based and charitable organizations and from the countless first responders and volunteers who are working tirelessly to help Louisiana recover. And my colleagues in Congress should provide, as I was saying, every necessary federal resource. We must do everything in our power to ensure that Southwest Louisiana is not forgotten as we work through the long and difficult recovery. I've seen firsthand the best of Louisiana, neighbors helping neighbors, communities coming together to rebuild and recover. It's what Louisiana does. We stand back up. Our people are resilient. We will rebuild. Louisiana, stand strong. You are not alone. You are loved. You are respected. You will never be forgotten. We stand with you as one through this recovery. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I yield.